Hi, I'm Gary from organicweb.com.au and I'm a Mailchimp Pro partner. I often get asked in my Mailchimp consulting and in my training classes what the difference is between Mailchimp segments, tags, and groups. So in this video, I'll go through the differences. We'll go into Mailchimp itself. The fundamental difference between them is that a group and a tag is data we add to a contact. So a group and a tag is data we add to a contact. A segment is search of existing data. It's not actually adding data against a contact, a segment. It's just a search or a filter. And I'll get onto that last. But for now, let's deal with tags and groups, the difference or the differences. You would use a group when you want people to choose their own preferences. You would use a tag where you don't want them to choose your own preferences. In other words, you want to label people. In Mailchimp, you'll notice I'm looking at my audience and you'll notice that we have the tags column. So that's where we see our tags. It's data we add. When we add a group, which we'll do very shortly, we'll see that there will be a column with our group name there and the entries that a person has chosen, for example, the groups, will appear here. So it's just data we're adding. Then we can segment or target our marketing using the data that's there. So groups we would use in our preferences center. Whenever we create a group in Mailchimp, by default, that group shows in the preferences center and your contacts can choose their options, their interests, for example, in the preferences center. The preferences center I go through in a separate video, so please watch my preferences center video. It'll tell you more about the preferences center. But tags don't show in the preferences center, but groups do. So let's create a group. I'm going to click manage contacts, groups. We'll wait for this to load up. And let's say we're a travel company, for example. We'll create a group, and what we're going to say in this group is what kind of travel do people like? Do they like, for example, luxury travel or budget travel, etc.? Because then we can target our marketing, and people can then say, no, I don't want to get, you know, budget travel information anymore. Maybe I only want to get luxury travel, for example. So let's click create groups. There are a few things to know here. You can have multiple groups, should you so wish, in Mailchimp. There is, however, a restriction of 60 group names per audience. That's quite a lot, but you can have 60 group names per audience, but you can have multiple group categories. So in this category, let's call this fave type travel. And we're going to get people to tell us their favorite type. Let's call this luxury. Let's call this budget. Let's call this family. And on we can go. We can add more groups if we want to. And as I said, there are a maximum of 60 group names you can have, and you can delete them at any time. We'll click save for now. And we could import immediately into this group so that our contacts are a member, as it were, of that group. But I'll click done for now. So we can see here that we now have a group category called favorite type of travel, and we have group names underneath that. So if we look at our audience itself, so I'll click all contacts, and what we'll see now is that we have a column here or a field called favorite type travel, and in there will appear whichever options the person chooses, such as luxury travel, budget, etc. And all the names will be comma separated and shown there, all the group names, sorry, that they've chosen. So again, that the group option will show in the preferences center so that people can choose their own options. Nice and handy. We can, if we want to, at any time, so people can add themselves, contacts can add themselves in the preferences center. We can, however, go to manage contacts, groups, view groups. And at any time, we can import into the individual group names, such as people that are interested in luxury travel. And we can even send immediately a campaign, for example, to all people that are interested in any of these category names. Back to our audience. So what is the difference between groups and tags? Well, as we've already said, or as I've said a little bit earlier, the group shows in the preferences center, the tag doesn't. So this is if you want to label your own contacts, and you can label them anything you want to. It's just a tag. You can label them anything you want to. The good thing about tags is it's unlimited the number of tags you have. You can have 100 tags if you want to. The only limit being that each tag can be a maximum of 100 characters in length. So people can't choose their own tags, but they can choose their own groups. Contacts, rather. Tags are nice and easy to manage. Let's say I want to add these three people as existing customers. I can just check their names, click add remove tags, and let's just say existing customer, for example. And I'll click on it. So what you'll notice is that it's just added the tag there. I can also, if I really want to, I could go into an individual person's name. I'll click this person's email address. It happens to be mine, but this person's email address. And I could click the plus. And let's say this person likes international travel. I can click on it. Sorry, there we go. And you'll see it adds on. Let's go back to all contacts. There's another way we can bulk tag contacts. We can click manage contacts, tags, or we can quite simply click tags to the left-hand side. And let's do this. Let's bulk tag contacts. And we can call it anything we want to. So let's say the destination. Let's say these are people that like traveling to Singapore. We could then import a list of people that are already in our audience. We could even paste email addresses of people that are already in our audience and save tag, and people will then be tagged as Singapore, because maybe they like to travel to Singapore or the USA or to Hawaii or wherever. We can also go, once again, manage contacts, tags. And at any time, against any tag we have, we can click the down arrow. Oops, sorry, it's not showing for you. The down arrow next to, sorry, I'm just going to move myself. Sorry, I'm getting in the way there. I can click the down arrow and click send, for example, and send a campaign immediately to the people that are tagged that. So again, going back to all contacts, and I'll just move myself across the screen very quickly again. Groups and tags, so there's tags and there's my group. Groups and tags are data that are added against a person. It's data that are stored against that contact details. A segment is something different. A segment is a search of existing data, whether that be a group, a tag, any other data. I do have other videos on this, but just to demonstrate, let's say I want to know all people whose first name is Jake. What I can do is create a segment. So what I'm looking for is first name contains Jake or is Jake. I'll go new segment and just select my options here. So I said I want to know my first name is Jake. And I can add more conditions. I could click add, for example. And what you'll be able to see here is I can even choose the groups I want to include. I can even include tags. And there's a lot of other things. So I could choose one of my groups where the person's chosen luxury, for example. But I'll just click the delete, click preview segment. So what Mailchimp has done here is it's just searched through my data and it's found everyone with my criteria. So first name is Jake. I can click save segment, and you can call the segment anything you want to. I'll just call it Jake, click save. I'll just refresh my audience to show what's happened here. At any time, I can click view segment and I could click on Jake, and Mailchimp will recalculate, at that time where the first name contains Jake. So it's dynamic in that way. So to summarize it all, groups tags, very similar, but the difference is that your contact can't choose their own tags, but they can choose their own group names. Tags are something that we add as the, for example, the administrator or the manager of the account. We can add against people's names. A segment is just a filter or search of any of the existing data that is in our audience. But thanks for joining me. I'm Gary from organicweb.com.au.